If you're trying to get everyone on the same page, you probably could use a knowledge base application. In this video, I'm going to be showing you the knowledge base template that Softr has recently updated for all of us to use. And within a few moments, you'll be able to see how you can install this very template in your own Softr account, launch it out to your own team, and make whatever customizations you need. So if learning more about creating a knowledge base application is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. And here it's our mission to help you unlock the full potential of no-code tools, empowering you to build powerful applications without needing to know any code. In this video, as I said, we're going to be taking a look at the new template from Softr for a knowledge base. But before we get into it, I first want to invite you to join me for a free pro subscription at Softr for 1 month. Softr has graciously given us a coupon code for this channel, and it's a great way for you to show some love back, but also get something in return. So go ahead and follow the steps that you see on your screen here to take advantage of 1 month free at Softr's pro subscription level. Without further ado, let's hop on into my screen, and I invite you to follow along with me in your own account. And here I am on the template page. So first and foremost, let's preview this template and see what it's all about. So what is a knowledge base? Well, frankly, it's a place for you to keep information and share it among your team. And here you'll see that we can preview this as many different types of people. And this, by the way, is fully customizable, fully available online. So you don't have to install the template before, you know, kind of exploring it and taking a look for yourself. But you can see here that we've got a lot of example people that we can impersonate. Any action that we take inside of the application when we are impersonating them is going to actually make changes to the application. Because Softr is the front end component to our application and the data lives somewhere else, but we can update, create new data, edit it, delete it. We can do all of that here inside of the app, and it is an immediate two-way sync between the Softr application, the front end, and our backend data source. Now, when we get to the part where we're actually implementing this and creating our version of the template, I'm going to create this in Airtable, but know that Softr can connect to over 14 different database applications or software, so you don't have to use Airtable as your backend. Now, again, I want to impersonate some folks here and see what they see. So first I'll pick an employee and I get the warning that any changes we make here as a user are going to actually be reflected in the underlying data. So this is what the application looks like for an employee. And you see that we've got the home on the left-hand side, we have our employee directory, and we have collections. And if we drill into collections, we can see that we have customer FAQs, product knowledge, sales enablement, and HR docs. So let's take a look at sales enablement. Let's imagine that I was a salesperson, a new hire at the team, and I wanted to see what this was all about. So here we are in our knowledge base, in our application, we're able to see all the different elements that we might need access to as a new person on this team. So I might want to click into the company logo, and this would open up. Company logo here. I can download the file right on my computer. This is just an example. If there's a URL that I need to go to, maybe it's a Loom video or a YouTube video for training, I could click on that. I can see when it was last updated and if I need to ask any questions here. You can see as an example that somebody's already started a little chat here, wondering if we have a black and white version of the logo. So I really enjoy having the chat enabled here in this block because we can, you know, collaborate better as a team. And that's part of the point of having a knowledge base. I can also scroll down and see other things like, you know, the sell sheet, custom order sheet, all the different assets that I need access to in one place. And that's the whole point of a knowledge base, that there's one central place that I can go and get all my questions answered as an employee. And that's great. But there are other roles as well. So what if I'm not an employee, but a manager instead? Let's impersonate what a manager would see when they are accessing the same template. So when I go to impersonate a different user, I get a different experience. And this is because the role of the user is decided by rules that we set up. And in this template, we have a manager role that is separate from the employee role. And so here you see that when I'm logged in as a manager, I get a lot more stuff that I have access to. As a manager, I get financial reports. Of course, we wouldn't expect an employee to have this kind of access, but I can view it as a manager and take a look at our profitability analysis, our Q1 cash flow statements, etc. And again, we've got files available here for download. We could click on links if we had them. We could collaborate and ask questions. You get the idea. Also, manager resources, another component available only to managers, not available to the employees. But here's some manager leadership training info. You get the idea. This is a place where, as an organization, we can consolidate and not have to worry about our people running all over the place to find answers to their questions, all of their resources, all of their training in one place. This way, we have a much more streamlined way of sharing information across an organization. And for the best part, I've saved it for last, this whole thing's gonna come together in a few moments. So after we've browsed the template, it's time for us to take ownership of it if we like it. Now, we're gonna create a copy of the template in our own Softr account, and then ultimately we can change our version of the Softr template to however we'd like, because we now own that version. So up here, we can click on Use Template. Or if we were back on the previous page, we could just say use template from the initial template page. So I'll make that selection here. Because I'm logged into Softr, it's going to already know where I need to install this template. It loads my workspace and it asks me to use the template again. And now it's going to ask me where the data is being stored. You'll notice I already have connections to Airtable, but I might want to start a new connection. So I can add another connection here. These are all the different databases that are also available here on Softr. But again, for this template, we're going to use Airtable. And the best part is, because the template was built with Airtable in mind as the back end, I don't have to create the Airtable base. I'll say continue here. Of course, I will grant it access to a base. I don't actually have a base for it yet, so I will say all of the bases in this workspace, grant access here. This is just integrating with Softr and Airtable, and now that I've built that connection, I can say copy template data. This is where we're creating a copy of the database, the Airtable backend. I'm creating a copy of that inside of my Airtable account. You can do this with a free Airtable plan, but of course understand that certain things are going to be limited based on your Airtable plan as well as your Softr plan. So you'll get more permissioning, more user capability, etc., the higher plans that you're on. So every use case is a little bit different, but if you have questions, feel free to reach out and ask. So here we go. I'm assigning my workspace where I want this Airtable database to be copied. And again, I'm copying the instance from Softr in real time. This is how quickly it goes. And bear in mind, I'm pausing here to talk every now and again. So it's really actually a lot quicker if you're just clicking from place to place. So here's all the sample data. I've got users, I have collections, content, comments, and then content requests. And one thing I want to highlight, if you recall, I was talking about the different roles that we have inside of the application. This is actually dictated by the role of the user inside the users table. So if we change someone from manager to employee to admin, their permissions and what they see in our application is going to change. So bear that in mind. So I've created a copy of the database. I head back to Softr now, and it knows that I've created a copy. Now I can go to the application, and this is where it's creating the front end, the Softr component. So we really can think of this in two different layers, the back end in Airtable, the front end in Softr. And just like that, I have my Softr application now built. All of my pages are available here. I can make changes to who can see them. Notice that by clicking here, I can change the group visibility. So maybe only specific users can access a page, as in the case of like manager resources. We're not sharing them with employees, so we can hide them here from the employee group. And so this is how we can grant the different permissioning at a page level, but we can do the same inside of those pages. We can hide certain elements as well. So if we wanted to hide this from managers, we could come in here and adjust this, right? Bring managers out of the visibility. And now that this is our application, we can make whatever changes we want. So any changes that we make in our version of this are going to be reflected only in our version. And then ultimately, we can deploy this to our team. We will scrub the existing users here on the left-hand side. Go ahead and you know, syncing, you can see that it's syncing with the Airtable users. We can remove all of these users and then ultimately go back into here in Airtable and put in the names and email addresses and make sure you get the proper role of everyone on your team. Just like that, they are going to get access to the application. You can ask them to either log in with a password, email verification with a code, or send magic links to them so that simple click gets them right inside the application. I know we went pretty quickly in this video, but let me know what different things you are using Softr for, or if there are videos about templates or different use cases in Softr that you would like to see. If you have questions, feel free to swing by our website. We have a ton of resources there. And if you got value from the video, we would love a thumbs up and a subscription to the channel. But most importantly, keep on building.